So I thought I'd show you a new gadget that I have that has just arrived. On the left, you can just about see the edge of my normal in-house espresso machine. I've just made a fresh espresso. Apologies, I haven't got any clear espresso cups. So like a glass will have to do, but that shows you what a house, the quality of a normal espresso machine makes. And this is called the Wacaco Nanopresso. The previous model was called the mini presso, and that had about 8 bar pump pressure. This has about 18 bar pump pressure, and it's effectively a portable espresso machine used mainly for things like camping. I intend to use this to take to work, put in my locker, and avoid having to keep going to the coffee shop and spending large amounts of money on espressos. So this is what you get: a nice little case, and here is the machine. Now I have actually pre-warmed this by putting a bit of hot water through it. You don't have to do that. And this is what you receive. On the bottom is so that's a brush to clean the machine with, and there's a measurer to be able to measure your coffee. That's the cup which you can use this as your espresso to actually drink your espresso, especially if you're out camping. I'm not intending to use this because I'll have a cup at work, so that just slots in here. So I said this is your water chamber, and there's a fill line here. I don't know if you can see that just below the light, and you're meant to put the water below that, otherwise it will burn you as you put it back together again. So there's the top of the machine, and if you just unscrew this top part. There, and that is your container for the coffee grounds, and there's the top of the machine. Okay, so what you do first, grab your coffee. I just happen to have some really ground coffee. This ground coffee would just be used for work, and so we grab out the measure. Now this should measure out about 8 grams or so of coffee. And the good thing about this is when you put this on, if you can see, this just fits on snugly, and then you won't really spill very much, which is actually quite useful, if you're, especially if you're out and about. And then you just use the top to tamp this down. Now, you shouldn't tamp it down too hard, but having said that, a normal espresso machine gives you 9 bar pump pressure. If this gives you 18, as the manufacturer says, then tamping down shouldn't be too much of an issue. Once that's done, you place this into the top here and you screw down the lid. Make sure you don't cross-thread it. Okay, next thing you do is you have to boil some water. Now, at work, the advantage of this machine is you can effectively use this as the basis of any drink. So, if you have hot milk as well, you can have lattes, you can have cappuccinos if you have a frother. So, it's quite useful. So, there's that fill line, remember. And I'm just going to see if you can see me fill this to the fill line, or just below there. Now you put this back on, it should not spill out, and then you turn it upside down, take out the pump, and then, now, you pump the plunger until you just about get a tiny bit of coffee coming through. Is there, and then you leave it for about 10 seconds to pre-infuse. That gives you slightly more flavour, and then you start doing a few pumps. Now I think this takes about 30 pumps to make your full espresso shot, and like I said, it's not a fantastic comparison. This has now been here for a few minutes. I made this, so the crema would have actually gone down, but you get a good idea of the comparison by just comparing them together. And then you just simply. Now it should be 1 per second, but I don't think it makes that much of a difference. I will do it as 1 per second though. at that. Now that's pretty much done. There you go, and you can't lose pressure, so you know you're done. Okay, put this to one side. And there we go, you can see the cascade here, there, and you can see the crema. So it's not quite as good as a normal espresso machine, it's pretty much the same there, and this has been out for some time. And it gives you slightly more than an espresso shot. So an espresso shot will be roughly 30 mils, a lungo is about 45 mils, and a ristretto is about 15 mils. I think this gives, after programming, about 32 to 35 mils, so just about an espresso shot. And you can see this is more like a lungo, but that is still lovely. In terms of taste, the normal espresso machine gives you fantastic flavour, fantastic full body. This is slightly thinner and slightly weaker, but that could just be the grounds, it could just be my technique and how I poured it. Overall, if a coffee machine gives you 9.5 to 10 out of 10, then I think this would probably be about 7 or 8 out of 10. It's the closest to an actual espresso that you actually get. £58, definitely worth it. Fantastic if you really can't live without coffee shops. If you go to work and you buy coffee from an average coffee shop, as a latte for instance, that would be costing you £2.50 a pop. If you drink a lot of coffee at work, this is definitely going to pay for itself over a period of about a month or so. One last quick thing to show you, just to see how easy it is. So when you take this off, all this is just simply just a tiny bit of water. It's actually clean. So you don't need to do anything there. And the brush can go straight back in. Put that back in there. And then that plunger goes back in. And on the top, the only cleaning you have to do is, again, this is fairly clean. Give this a whiz. Is to actually take the puck out, clean the head, and clean the puck out. And that's it. There we go. Put them back together again. All very clean. All very easy to do. We're effectively just have to clean the top compartment. Screw it all back together again, into its case, stored away in your locker, obviously if you're camping, stored away in your bag. Very easy to make, very quick, and tastes really, really nice. Cheers.